Everybody, this is Perch. Ben Percy asked the question, what does it take to have a definitive run? A lot of people talk about definitive runs on comics, but what does that mean? And he was addressing it kind of as a volume kind of question, which makes sense, by the way. If you're talking about a run, it typically is a volume of comics, or at least a time plan. And he said, what is a definitive run? Is it 6 issues? Is it 12 issues? 24? You know, 37? What is a definitive run? I think there's probably a lot of different answers to this question, but for me, the definitive run is really not limited by the amount. I think there are some creators who've done some definitive work in, you know, under 12 issues. I think it's possible. I think a definitive run, at least for me, is something that captures the spirit of the character, which doesn't have to be the main character, by the way. You can have a definitive run of Elektra within the pages of Daredevil, for example. But and that's why I think, you know, saying you can't have a 50-issue arc, you know, it doesn't need to be like this big amount of comics in order to have a definitive run. I think you can have a definitive run on a character, you know, with pretty short amount of time. What times have you nailed that character in a pretty small amount of comics? I think that the heart of it, though, is that you've got to be able to create a story that really boils down the essence of the character or redefines them in a way that is logical. And it's the second part, I think, that is so difficult for a lot of current writers, because there is this desire, at least, to want to, you know, change everything you've ever known about a character. It's a cliche. I would argue that the cliche of what you thought you knew was wrong is a much bigger and more tired cliche than this character is shockingly going to die. To me, I think their history was not what you thought it was is a more tired and eye-rolling at this point, which really says a lot given how comics overuse death. But so if you're going to do something where you redefine the nature of a character, and I'll pick on what a lot of people have listed Hawkeye, the Matt Fraction of the 12-issue series, as being a definitive run on a character. Other people have said Vision, the 12-issue series by Tom King, has been a definitive run of the character. And I'm not going to argue with either of those points. I think, though, that one is a better example than the other. I think with the Vision, it took this character that in many cases was both defined and undefined. The Vision was always a kind of an oddball character in the pages of the Avengers. It's somebody who, you know, had his origin in an inhuman way. It would often grapple with ideas of, am I human, am I not human, with this desire to, I want to be human. We've had the Vision try and take over, you know, the government at different times. We've had various instances. We've had him taken completely apart and then put back together where there was no emotion. We've had, of course, his relationship with the Scarlet Witch and everything that went on there. So we've had different instances of the Vision as has been presented to us. And in Tom King's 12-issue run, we basically saw the Vision still grappling and wrestling with those same things, but deciding to do it in a fundamentally different way. Rather than try and fit in with society, he would try and mimic human society while still being who he was with this entirely robot family. It was an extension of the stories we've heard in the past. I don't know. The other part of definitive run is it has to hold up over time. I think something may feel like a definitive run, and then you come around to it, you know, 20 years later, and it no longer matters. Maybe because other writers have come along and made a more definitive run, or because the changes that were made were, you know, by and large, completely ignored by the publisher. I think that there's a risk of that happening, certainly with the Vision comic that Tom King did. They played around with his daughter. Viv Vision is still somebody who kind of wanders into the Champions at any, you know, in various given moments. They're doing a kind of race identity thing because you can't stick with just people. You have to go, you know, we have to bring racial sensitivity into it as well, which does seem a little bit odd when you have a robot character, but whatever, you know, whatever, if the story's good, whatever you want to do. But it feels like that definitive run of Tom King's is slowly being erased. Now, by contrast, I think you have the Hawkeye run by Matt Fraction. And this is a run where Hawkeye was boiled down, again, took certain elements of his personality and made him more of a loser, made him more of a kind of somebody who tries to be a hero, but just kind of sucks at it. In this case, the definitive aspect of that run was to kind of chip away aspects of that character. If you look at Hawkeye from his early days in the Avengers, and then kind of his rise, a chip on his shoulder to wanting to lead, but maybe not having the skills to do it, to finally his West Coast Avengers run, kind of where he went through there, coming back into the Avengers proper, just this kind of various arc, him getting killed and then brought back to life, and how that changed his personality. And then it was the Fraction run basically discarded everything that was inconvenient to the story that wanted to be told, which is kind of this hapless screw up kind of superhero, but also a, you know, not a very good or very capable person. It basically dumped everything, all of the heroic growth for the character in favor of something that was a little bit more wacky and all the rest. And so I would say the Matt Fraction run is not a definitive run of the character, even though it was a memorable one, even though it took and it really distilled into these core personality attributes and it ran with it. It wasn't, I don't think that's a great example of a definitive run for the character. Now, kind of using the exact opposite argument I used for The Vision with Tom King, other writers have come along and basically stuck with Matt Fraction's run. So I think there's in weird way, the Vision run by Tom King was a more definitive run of the character that is getting eroded over time. The Hawkeye run, I would say, was not a definitive run of the character, but is getting strengthened over time. The opposite thing is happening. The more other writers decide, yes, this is canon, this is the personality we want, this is the character we want, the more they do that, the more that run becomes definitive, the more it basically sets in stone what was made there. To me, that's kind of how I think about definitive runs. Both those are 12 issues. I think you could do it in six. I think there are aspects of what Mark Miller did for Wolverine and Enemy of the State that I believe was six issues. I think you can pull stuff like that off. I think Frank Miller has different periods where he's done it in a few issues. I mean, you know, Return of the Dark Knight was four issues, three issues? I mean, that was a fairly short comic, longer pages, that managed to be a definitive run of the character. Batman Year One is a definitive run of the character. That's certainly not tons and tons of comics. So I don't think it has anything to do with length. I don't think you have to get to... it's not the size, it's what you do with it. There's the line everybody was waiting to hear. In many cases, I think that, you know, people often point to Chris Claremont having a definitive run of the X-Men. I think he definitely did. But I think that was more, I would almost turn around and say it was more of a definitive run of Chris Claremont as opposed to a definitive run on the X-Men, because I think Chris Claremont did certain things, whether it was Dark Phoenix saga or kind of the, you know, post Fall of the Mutants, the Australia arc of what he did there, or just, I think there's different moments of Chris Claremont's run that had some definitive character arcs, whereas the creator being on a title for any length of time and sticking with it and being able to pull off big things. I think John Byrne's Fantastic Four run. I think Wolfman's various runs that he did. I think there's Mark Guggenheim had some definitive runs, Roger Stern. I think there's some different people who've had definitive runs for the creator. But in terms of the actual comic itself, the characters, I think I would look at it a little bit differently, like I have. But what about you? What do you think, what makes a definitive run of a comic or a character for you? And what are some of those definitive runs you really, really remember? What are the ones that have held up over time? And what are the ones that maybe felt like definitive runs that collapsed over time? I think there's examples of both that I'm sure people probably have in their minds. So if you don't mind, throw them in the comments below. Let's hear what you think a definitive run is. And I guess one last question. Are definitive runs meaningful in comics? Do comics need to have definitive runs? Or are we moving to this world of, you know, hey, a couple issues here and OG in there, and, you know, the story is all that matters. We shouldn't be thinking about runs anymore. Runs is an old concept that no longer has any meaning in today's comic market. God, that's a terrifying thought. But anyway, is that what you think? Let me know in the comments below. Otherwise, hey, like and subscribe. You can see where to get in touch with me from the description of this video. But otherwise, thanks for listening.